didn't expect that. Clearly, it's been a little bit since I last played Star Wars The Old Republic. Okay, I wasn't sure if they were going into a cinematic cutscene or not. I don't think they will. But anyway, let me just see. Okay, good. Just gonna start up. Cool. yeah. Hello, everyone. This is Archive of 12. And today, obviously, as you can see, we are going to be playing Star Wars The Old Republic. And I think because it has been so long, we are going to continue on with Gary the Stormtrooper. Because, you know, it's been almost 7 months. I'm just checking on this on my phone right now. Videos. When was the last episode released and what was it about? Released a long time ago. A long, long time ago. Okay, I think the last episode, if I'm remembering right, was episode 27, which had us going through Belsavis, which is a world that I hate. Absolutely. Undeniably. I cannot stand Belsavis. It's just a rat's nest, a maze of just convoluted, broken prison cells. But we were there to exfiltrate a group of Republic pilots that had been more or less condemned to rot in prison for the rest of their lives because they bombed an area that had civilians in it. And that's not cool, obviously. They were given bad intel and they attacked what they thought was an Imperial stronghold, but it turned out to be a city, I think, or a town. And they were looking for a specific Sith Lord, and they attempted to kill him in this bombing run, and they failed. And on top of that, they also ended up killing a bunch of innocent civilians that got caught in the crossfire. So they were charged, they were sentenced, and they were sent to Belsavis, and they were meant to be forgotten. But because the way this is the nature of politics and war, we require their assistance again because they were the best starfighter pilots the Republic had, and we need them in order to break General Rakton, who, as you know, is attempting to restart the war between the Galactic Republic and the Sith Empire. And so our faithful stormtrooper managed to get in there, take out the Imperials that were invading Belsavis, and stop all that nonsense, as well as exfiltrate every single pilot in the prison. So yeah, that's good. We've got ourselves more assets. So now we continue on with our next mission. So without further ado, let's get started. Oh, a lot of people want to talk to me. Okay, well, let's get some of these conversations done first.
Sir, I'm afraid I need to request a brief leave of absence. It's Kalor. He's attempting to exploit a loophole in Investigative Appeals Process Subsection 4 in order to reopen his inquiry without new cause.
I think it's time to introduce that scumbag to the roomier end of an airlock.
That won't be necessary. I'm not going to give Kalor the time to carry his supposed investigation any further. I'm going to Coruscant. I have every message, every report, every call recorded. It's time to demonstrate to Kalor's superiors exactly what his supposed service to the Republic has accomplished.
I'll come with you. With my word backing you up, you can't fail.
You're very kind to offer, sir, but I need to handle this myself. Bringing a war hero along would seem like a diversionary tactic.
I suppose that's true.
Quickly as possible.
Suppose that's true. Still, I don't like it. Time pass.
I am ordered to report that I, Alara Dawn, personnel number 22795, am no longer classified as a person of concern.
Excellent.
Personnel division of the Army of the Galactic Republic has declared that I am to be treated as a fully protected legal citizen, effective immediately.
That's awesome.
Tell me everything. What about Kalor?
Kalor never saw it coming. When I exercised my right under Service Code 1 to an immediate personnel hearing, he was literally speechless. I demonstrated documentation for every moment of his pointless investigation. Once the man hours and expenditures were totaled, it came to thousands of credits wasted in wartime.
I can't believe it had really gone so far.
Yes. Even after I had gathered all of that evidence, the full scale of what had happened didn't settle in until I was presenting it in the hearing. I still can't believe this day has finally come. The suspicion, the reservations, the endless questions. They've been a part of my life for so long. But no more. I am a citizen of the Galactic Republic.
It's great to see this happening for you.
Thank you so much. I've never felt prouder to be serving the Republic. Let's return to the front lines. I want to go back to doing my part.
You don't need some time to let this all settle in?
No. There's nowhere I'd rather be than fighting with my fellow soldiers of the Republic.
That's the type of Alara that I like hearing. Not the robotic, rule-touting version, but the impassioned, like, emboldened individual that she just became with that conversation.
I may have been wrong about you. Takes a lot to lead a squad like Havoc. Wasn't convinced you had it in you. Thought you were inexperienced, untested. But you've got good instincts. Turned out to be a first-class leader.
Aw. This is a historic moment.
Wait, let me record this. I need proof.
Let's not make a big deal out of this. I'll admit, that business on Ord Mantell still irks me. But it landed me in the most elite squad in the Republic, under one of the finest commanders I've served with. So I can't complain too much.
Everything worked out in the end.
Sir, I found information on weapons projects that Colonel Rebus was involved in. Would you like to hear about them?
Rebus. Oh, right, the guy that he's been tailing and kind of harassing through his underlings. Got it.
What has Colonel Rebus been up to?
Most recently, Colonel Rebus was involved in the Gauntlet superweapon that we so skillfully destroyed. He's had a hand in many other projects over the past 18 years. The Blight Matrix, the Galactophage, Subjugation Droids, even the Plasm Resource. Supposedly, he even designed a device that could permanently block hyperlanes, though the project was scrapped due to power limitations.
First of all, Galactophage reminds me of the Genophage from Mass Effect. Second of all, permanently blocking galactic hyperlanes seems like a very, very obtuse and stupid idea.
Rebus sounds like an experienced mass murderer.
It's unlikely that anyone in the galaxy has more experience in this field than Rebus. Once his new project enters the testing phase, we will stand a much better chance of locating Rebus himself. I will report to you as soon as I know more.
What led you to sign up for the army?
I like Yun so much. He's such an interesting character. So, like, knowledgeable and spiritual and yet very pragmatic.
Did the enlistment officers know what to do with you?
Kind of you need to keep your request out after we'll start my doubt. Everybody is like, oh yeah, let's reflect on our past successes and how we got here. Kind of touching, actually.
I have to tell you, boss, I'm impressed. I wasn't sure I'd like coming back to the army, but it's worked out great, mostly thanks to you.
I'm just lucky to have a good team.
Can't have a good crew without a good boss, sir. I've worked with a lot of people over the years. Stupid, greedy people I cut loose as soon as I could. But you? Actually useful. Even taught me a thing or two in a fight. That's a nice change.
Wow. Was that a compliment? I think that was a compliment.
I enjoy working with you too, Vic.
Of course you do. These ops wouldn't be any fun without me around. Come on, let's get back to that war I keep hearing about.
Oh, Vic has a lot to talk about. Okay.
Found our first customer, boss. An Alderaanian noble named Albrecht. He was into Magarin for quite a few credits. Once I work out the final details, it's all ours.
Magarin's files didn't have everything we need?
Not gonna chance it. With Alderaan as torn up as it is, it's best to do some research first. I've got a good feeling about this, boss. I think this might just be the best plan I've ever been part of. Long as we're not kicked out of the military, we'll do pretty well for ourselves.
Well, that's reassuring.
What got you kicked out before?
I don't remember half the list of charges. You know me. Like to keep busy. The last straw was a protection racket I ran while I was stationed on Talay. It was really fun while it lasted. The plan only worked for a few weeks before someone whined to the higher-ups. I was the ringleader, so I took most of the heat.
Not easy being in charge, is it?
Nope. Glad I don't have to deal with that nonsense anymore. I'll let you know when everything's lined up. Then I'll go pay the noble Lord Albrecht a visit.
Ah, Vic is a nice guy. With some questionable priorities. Alright, no more dilly-dallying. Time to initiate this mission.
Havoc Squad calling Sergeant Jaxo. Come in, Jaxo.
After all these hours, I'd be happy to see anybody's face. But you just made my decade.
I couldn't leave you hanging, could I?
I knew there was a reason you were always my favorite. From here, I can short out the exterior defense grid. You'll be able to coast right in. But internal security is a whole other problem. We've got war droids and plenty of them. There's gonna be some major heat after you touch down, believe me.
Thanks for the heads up, Jaxo.
You'd better make your approach now. I'll contact you once you're landed. Jaxo out.
All right, that's the, okay. As we fly right into the asteroid. All right, Alora. Let's get this interrogation data and rendezvous with Jaxo and rescue all these people. Door is locked. Is there a security console somewhere? Maybe this one's unlocked. Yep, that one's unlocked. I've been playing a lot of Star Trek Online. I forget there's no flanking damage here. Both of them. That's enough of that.
I'd call that a beachhead, but you'd better leave plenty of muscle behind. Your ship is going to be target number one for those droids.
Those droids won't put a scratch on my ship.
Let's hope not. It's a long walk home. Next up is the command center. That's where you'll need to go to open all of the cells. Once our boys are loose, they can ride out in one of the old supply transports. It'll be a tight fit, but I doubt anyone will complain.
How are you getting out of here, Jaxo?
Much as I'd like to ride out with you, I think I'd better help the others get that transport running. Good luck, Major.
I don't know if Alara knows that Jaxo and I have shacked up a couple of times, but this could get very awkward very quickly.
Ah! Don't shoot! Don't shoot! I surrender! You're Republic, right? This is a jailbreak. Please, I'll do whatever you want. Just don't hurt me.
Cooperate and I'll get you out of here too.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. You want me to unlock the prisoner cells? I can do it. It'll only take about... Oh, General Rakton.
Hello.
Impressive. Your time from learning about A-77 to storming its command deck was shorter than even my most aggressive estimates.
Havoc is number one for a reason, Rakton.
That will be coming to an end very soon.
Uh-oh.
Imperial warships have maneuvered into position around A-77. The facility will be obliterated in a matter of minutes. Goodbye.
That's not good.
The shields are already failing. I have to reroute power.
You want to give me an update here, Major? It feels like someone's shooting at us.
The imps are about to blow this whole place apart.
They're going to blow up their own prison? This is insane.
Oh, I can do it. I can keep the shields up. We can all make it out if I just vent the systems level.
You can't vent the systems level. I'm on the systems level. There are droids everywhere. I'd never make it out. Who is this moron?
Is there any other way to get the shields up?
There is no other way. Please forgive me, but we have no other alternative.
Uh-oh.
Without shields, we could never get the cells open fast enough. All of the prisoners would die.
You've got to get me out of here, Major. I can't die in this place. I can't.
We have no choice. We're clearly compelled to rescue the greatest number of prisoners possible.
There's always a choice. Please, don't do this.
I'm sorry, Jaxo. It was fun, but there are hundreds of people here. I can't risk them all for one person.
Forgive me, Jaxo, but this is my only option. Vent the service level. Get the shields back up and the prison cells open ASAP.
Yes! Yes, of course!
But, no. It can't end like this. It can't end.
And they make you listen to it.
Shields are back to 90%, but they will not last forever. You should return to your ship. I'll ensure the prisoners are freed and find their way to the transport.
Don't hang around too long yourself.
I will not. Thank you. Please, go now. We don't have much time.
I'm just glad they didn't have a cut.
Attention, prisoners. Republic soldiers have come to rescue you. All cells are being unlocked and opened now. Please hurry to the aft hangar bay. A supply transport is available to carry you away from this place. At last!
I'm just glad that they didn't make us watch what happened to Jaxo, because that would be awful. Well, crap.
Havoc! Hey there. We just wanted to thank you for springing us. No time for introductions before. I'm Major Fell, 82nd Armored. I always wanted to meet the head of Havoc. This is a real honor.
Are your people going to be all right?
I think so. The imps weren't easy on us, but that's all over now. I guess you found us on account of Jaxo. Is she over there? I'd like to thank her too, if I could.
Unfortunately, Jaxo was killed during the escape.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize. She ought to get a medal. We'd never have gotten out if she hadn't slipped away to call for help.
I'll be sure to suggest it to my CO.
Thank you. It seems like the least we could do to try and repay her. I won't hold you up any longer. Thanks again, Major. From all of us. Fell out.
Havoc Squad calling General Garza. A-77 was a trap. We rescued most of the prisoners, but Sergeant Jaxo was killed in action.
I'm sorry to hear about Jaxo. But it sounds like you were very fortunate to save as many as you did. What happened exactly?
General Rakton had warships waiting to destroy A-77 and kill us all.
Incredible. You did very well to escape a situation like that, Major. Tell me more about Sergeant Jaxo. Was she killed during the operation, or had she been recaptured before you arrived?
Jaxo sacrificed her life to save the others. She deserves a posthumous award.
Understood. I'll get the documentation started immediately. It's the least we could do. General Rakton is going to great lengths to remove Havoc from the war. We're clearly on the right track. Let's keep the pressure on. Your next assignment is on a planet called Voss. I'm sending the coordinates now. Contact me as soon as you arrive. Garza out.
Ah, Voss. All right. Well, that was a an eventful mission. But I think I'm going to wrap things up here. Gary the Stormtrooper is back on the channel. I am working very hard to try and get things that I haven't played in a while back in rotation, including Gary's storyline. So keep an eye out for more of that stuff. In the meantime, thank you for joining me. This was Archive 12, and I shall see you in the next video.